Today is the feast of St. Clement, who was the fourth bishop of Rome, third after Peter. And like most of the popes of the first 250 years, he died a martyr's death. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The Lord be with you. Let us call to mind our common sin. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father. Lord, have mercy. You bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy. You give light and hope to those who live in darkness. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living Father, who are wonderful in the virtue of all your saints, grant us joy in the yearly commemoration of St. Clement I, who, as a martyr and high priest of your Son, bore out by his witness what he celebrated in mystery, and confirmed by example what he preached with his lips. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, looked, and there was the Lamb standing on Mount Zion, and with him 144,000, who had his name and his Father's name written on their foreheads. I heard a sound from heaven, like the sound of rushing water or a loud peal of thunder. The sound I heard was like that of harpers playing their harps. They were singing what seemed to be a new hymn before the throne, before the four living creatures and the elders. No one could learn this hymn except the 144,000 who had been ransomed from the earth. These are the ones who follow the Lamb wherever he goes. They have been ransomed as the first fruits of the human race for God and the Lamb. On their lips, no deceit has been found. They are unblemished. The word of the Lord. Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face.
Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face.
The Lord's are the earth and its fullness, the world and those who dwell in it. For he founded upon the seas and established it upon the rivers.
Lord, this is the people who longs to see your face.
Who can ascend the mountain of the Lord, or who may stand in his holy place? He whose hands are sinless, whose heart is clean, who desires not what is vain.
Lord, this is the people who longs to see your face.
He shall receive a blessing from the Lord, the reward from God his Savior. Such is the race that seeks for him, that seeks the face of the God of Israel.
Lord, this is the people.
The Lord be with you. Reading from the 21st chapter of the Holy Gospel according to Luke. When Jesus looked up, he saw some wealthy people putting their offerings into the treasury, and he noticed a poor widow putting in two small coins. He said, I tell you truly, this poor widow put in more than all the rest, for those others have all made offerings from their surplus wealth. But she, from her poverty, has offered In the New Testament, despite our protestations to the contrary, money, disposable wealth, income, is very important. Last week we read about Zacchaeus, the guy up in the tree came down, I can fourfold anybody I've cheated, half my wealth goes to the poor. Jesus says, this day salvation has come to this house of Zacchaeus the tax collector. Pretty powerful words based on his spending his disposable income. Yesterday we had the most powerful reading in the whole New Testament. You only need to read it once and you can never forget it. And Jesus said to those coming into the kingdom of his Father, I was hungry, you fed me. I was naked, you clothed me. I was homeless, you took me in. And we know the sad ending, right? I was hungry, you did not feed me. Naked, you did not clothe me. And those were the ones who went off to eternal damnation. Powerful stuff, money. And it comes up often. Money has two meanings to it, as you know. The end for which we use it, and we use it for a thousand different reasons. But the money that we give away will probably fall into, for us as Christians, believers, two big categories. One will be the temple, the house of the Lord, always very important to us, and we will remodel and paint and clean the house of the Lord regularly. We are not comfortable if our churches are dirty or dilapidated or ill-kept, so we normally will do that in a four-year project. I'm sure we'll all be very proud of it. And the second thing will be for the poor and oppressed. And we use it for other good things too, practice building a $12.5 million expansion, and we hope that the kids who will go there in future years will be even better prepared to go into the world and to serve others through their talents. So there are many very good reasons for which we give money, spend our money. But in the spending, giving it over, we also define who we are. We tell the world, or at least we tell ourselves, and undoubtedly we tell our Lord, who we are. Who is that person in there? And today's gospel has nothing to do with remodeling the temple in Jerusalem. Wouldn't have hardly paid the cleaning lady for 10 minutes. Wouldn't probably give a lot of food to the poor. Jesus has this moment. St. Luke includes these vignettes, these very beautiful teaching moments. And Jesus is in the temple for this period from the time he came in, the triumphant entry into Jerusalem till his passion and death. Luke has a lot of stuff in there. The other Gospels don't have it. And he's normally hanging around the temple. Two reasons. One, it probably was simply safe for him to be there. Nobody was going to arrest him in front of the people because they liked him. And so when he would walk into the temple in the morning, inevitably people would come up to him. They had questions from the last time they heard him speak. And he probably would stop and enjoy the questions and work over them and talk to the people and crowd around a little bit. And on this one day, while he was sort of pondering their questions, he saw a woman probably pass by him 15, 20 feet away. He went by the collection place. And he could tell she was a poor woman by her dress, imagine. And he may have even heard the clink when the two quarters into the plate. He probably thought to himself, isn't that he lives off $1 a day? Would be average for poor widows. And she gave 50 cents. So he stops this discussion and turns to the people and says, you see that woman? She's given more than all the rest. And it was the revelation of who she was in her heart. Why we use money has a thousand different reasons, but a gratitude to the God who gave her the gift of life and who somehow was sustaining her. And the second was to try to help those who probably were less well off than she was. Now, I'm not sure she could have said that. I said, why did you put that money in? She said, oh, well, give me a few minutes to think about it. But it was obvious why she put the money in there, and it was very important to her, but something that wasn't going to bring about any great change. And so we see again the importance of wealth, how it defines us, it says who we are inside ourselves by how we use our disposable income. What would the Lord say to you and I? Probably the same thing he said to the little crowd around you. When you leave today, go home, on your way home, in your home, ask yourself, what does money mean to you? And then we'll discuss it in a day or two again. As members of God's kingdom, let us together offer our petitions to our Heavenly Father. For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, may God continue to bless him in shepherding and reforming the Church. Let us pray to the Lord. For all of our newly elected government officials, that the Lord may grant them the gift of wisdom and courage in their new offices, let us pray to the Lord. For the sick, the poor, the hungry, for the victims of the coronavirus and their families, the Lord may bless them with good health and restoration. And for those who work to overcome the virus, let us pray to the Lord. For all who have died or faithfully departed, especially those that have died in the past year, to those listed in our November Book of Remembrance, may they be received into the eternal dwelling made ready for them in heaven. Today we offer the orders of Mr. Ed McCormick and for all our department. Let us pray to the Lord. Let us pause now for our own intentions. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord God, as we celebrate your almighty kingship, we offer our prayers and ask that you answer them according to your holy will. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. Lord, wash away my iniquity, cleanse me of all my sins. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Amen. Accept, O Lord, these sacred offerings which at your bidding we dedicate to your name on this feast of St. Clement. And in order that through these gifts we may become worthy of your divine love, grant us unfailing obedience to your commands. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the blood of your blessed martyr, Saint Clement, poured out like Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear you witness through Christ our Lord. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly here on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Lawrence, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you all. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
please carefully maintain social distancing when you come up for communion. a prayer for spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot receive you at this moment sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. We pray, merciful Father, that those to whom you give the joy of participating in divine mysteries on this feast of St. Clement may never be parted from you. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.